When the Oregon Ducks defeated the Wisconsin Badgers in last week's Rose Bowl, they looked less like football players and more like comic book superheroes, sporting mirrored special edition helmets that had never been worn before.
Oh, wow. Look at that helmet. Can you believe that?
In fact, the Ducks haven't worn the same exact uniform for two games in a row since 2004. Portland-based Nike has outfitted the Ducks since 1996. Todd Van Horn is the designer.
Again, we're getting lighter weight. We've got stretch panels through here. It's completely 360-degree materials, zone ventilation through a lot of this. So we're bringing out
the changes, he says, are all in the service of performance. Now, the duck wings are very functional.
That's the primary intent. Right. It has durability. You know, it protects from, you know, the hits from other helmets or chin straps or, you know, face guards that would actually nick the material itself. So it makes it stronger.
But this is about more than functionality.
Who are you wearing? Who are you wearing tonight?
This season alone, the Ducks wore 8 different jerseys, 6 pants, 5 helmets, 6 different shoes, and 4 sock colors. A staggering number of possible combinations.
Oregon over the last decade or so has really pioneered the idea that nothing is out of bounds, we can do anything, we can push the envelope, and that really what we stand for is constant change.
So that's become their tradition.
Yeah, exactly.
ESPN's Paul Lucas is founder of UniWatch.com. He says college football uniforms have been changing ever since colleges have played football. In the beginning, uniforms were made of wool and had long sleeves.
And were the helmets cloth or leather?
Well, first there were no helmets in the beginning. Some players used a little device that strapped around their head and just covered their nose. It was like a little shield that covered their nose area, and that was the first quote-unquote helmet or face mask or face guard.
As for why today's players wear their jerseys skin tight,
It's really about this hand-to-hand combat, and anything hand-to-hand, you don't want those hands to be grabbing anything.
It looks like it fits you really well.
Yeah.
There's no grab points for the opponents through here,
right.
So I think you're, I think you're game ready.
The Ducks have turned the gridiron into a catwalk, and other schools are following suit. Maryland's Terrapins were cheered and jeered when they debuted their Maryland Pride uniforms, taking the state's flag and wrapping the players in it.
The biggest thing is, you know, people are talking about Maryland and they're talking about the uniforms. And when anytime anybody's talking about you, it's all good.
If you think these uniforms are a little too fashion forward, don't tell Coach Randy Edsel.
Would you ever think of sending the offensive line up to Fashion Week in New York?
With our uniforms? Oh, most definitely. They'd be the hit. Seeing them big guys walking out there with those uniforms. When we had our show here, the runway, those guys were a hit.
Yes, the Maryland players had a runway show featuring this season's collection. And this year, even tradition-bound Notre Dame succumbed to the pressure to flash up their look. We wondered if other squads should change up their look, so we brought in Barney's creative director, Simon Doonan, for some fashion advice. Modeling for us, Columbia University football players Nick and Mike.
Simon, Nick is wearing Wyoming.
This feels very spring to me. Well, it's sharp, it's crisp, it's good on the runway, but most importantly, right, it's good on the football field.
And he had only kudos for Arizona State's Sun Devils.
I love it. The burgundy, it looks incredible on the field, you know, with all that green.
But when it came to Hawaii's Rainbow Warriors?
Well, I have to say, I'm a little disappointed. Hawaii, one thinks of luau's and tiki and all that great iconography.
It seems like a little bit tiki there, is that right? But you want more.
This is very subtle tiki. To me, subtle tiki is no tiki. I want my tiki full on.
Yeah.
The sports trouser could also be printed a la grass skirt.
Oh, I like that.
Hello, a photo print, you know? Now we're getting creative.
By now, you may be wondering, why does any of this matter? Paul Lucas says a uniform may tell you a lot about a team's heritage, but he doesn't think it has much to do with their success on the field.
You take a school like Nebraska, and they have one of the plainer looking uniforms. They have a really plain helmet with the N on it, you know, and they sell out every game. So obviously the uniforms aren't what's driving attendance there. It's their history, it's their heritage, it's their success. Nothing looks better on the field at the end of the game than having more points than your opponent.
A flashy uniform may not mean more points, but it does mean more dollars.
The biggest thing that has changed in terms of what drives it is that when you and I were kids, you couldn't go and buy a jersey. That market didn't exist. They hadn't figured out that someone would drop $200 for a polyester shirt. And now that they know people will do that, well, you already bought this year's jersey. Well, what if we change our jersey next year? You'll go buy another one. And so that's like the merchandising tail wags the on-field dog in a way that it wasn't necessary or even possible 30, 40 years ago.
And while the Oregon Ducks may be trendsetters and Rose Bowl champs, Maryland ended the season with 2 wins and 10 losses.
It's one thing to look like a clown and win, then you're a winner. If you look like a clown and lose, you're just a clown.